Hey, it's Disney Queen Skelly here, and welcome back to another Chatting Skeletons, quote-unquote, podcast. So, yeah, today's subject, my extensive love life. I'm not proud of it. I've always been, like, a boy-crazy girl ever since I was, like, younger. And, I don't know, I guess I've made some pretty bad choices in my dating life before now. I'm not going to put names to people, but when I was younger, I'd say back in middle school, I had like my first, I guess you would call it a quote-unquote long-term relationship. And I mean, it only lasted really 4 months, but I mean, in middle school, what more could you really ask for? I did end it with him. I probably shouldn't have, but he was a really good guy, good kid. We'd stayed friends up until after our first year of college, and then we kind of fell out, which is sad because he was always that guy friend I needed that really just smacked me back into reality. Nothing wrong with him. In fact, my parents liked him, but, you know, when you're 12 years old, you're not really thinking all that much, are you? Then in high school, I was dating this one kid who, in fact, turned out to be gay. And we dated for nearly half a year. Don't ask me how that worked out. But with all this being said, just understand that I'm trying to give you guys somewhat of a life lesson in terms of how I hope you guys take your relationships. Because I didn't do so well in mine, and of course that did lead me to where I am today with the best relationship I've ever had. But I just want you guys to be safe. In high school, while I was dating this one guy, I met his best friend who I actually fell for. We dated about 2 years on and off, and I lost my virginity to him when I was about 16. Biggest regret of my life. But at the same time, I can't call it a regret because it gave me about 5 years, 6 years of experience that I'm really proud of that I have, and I'm glad I'm not in this, like, bubble of not knowing what to do, so I kind of take pride in that. I know what I'm doing at least somewhat, but I'm still learning new things since it hasn't really been that long. But that relationship didn't end well. And after I dated him, and I'll be honest, I'm really only counting my long-term relationships, not the mini ones in between, because frankly, I don't count those. After him, I dated someone about 3 years younger than me for about half a year, and I really messed up on that relationship. That was my fault, personally. But I lost a friend because of it, and not only that, I lost the respect of someone who I probably could have been friends with, who I probably should not have been really dating in the first place. But after him, I dated this one other guy who haunted my life for 3 years, and it was a very abusive relationship. He wouldn't pay attention to me. Everything would be my fault. It was just terrible. I always thought that I was in the wrong every single time. When looking back, it was always him, and my friends knew it. And they were nice enough really not to yell at me or say anything, but they were there for me to support me and just be there for me whenever I did need help. Thankfully, that person is no longer in my life. And I will say this, though. Each one of these people that I went out with gave me something to look at in terms of who I am as a person, what I could develop from these relationships and how I could better myself in further relationships to come. Now, yes, it's scary when you have to break up with someone or when someone breaks up with you, because breaking up is never really fun. And given that I've had only a few long-term relationships and little mini flings here and there, I'm not proud of any of them. But I will say that each of them gave me a lesson to take forward into what I could find in my long-term love life. Which is exactly what happened. I found someone who fits me like a puzzle piece, who understands me more than anyone has really ever understood me, and who will be there for me until death do us part. What I want you guys to take away from this is we're all going to have relationships, hopefully. We're all going to have crushes on somebody. We're all hopefully going to at least find somebody. And when you do, really look at them, explore them, see who they really are. And if they feel like the perfect fit to you, go for it. But understand the difference between love and lust. When you lust after somebody, it means you're only in it for maybe the thrill of love, that you're only really in it for like the sexual tension it could bring in a way. You're not looking for the emotional attraction, more the physical attraction. And that's okay for now. I mean, when you're young, it's not wrong to just shop around. I mean, no one said you had to find your Prince Charming at the age of like 12. Romeo and Juliet is such a bad example. But, you know, as extensive as my love life is, like I said, each one just gave me something to look at. And I know it's not really fair to say that, you know, I found someone so quick, because it really took me a long time to find the person I was with. It took trial and error. It took, you know, so much hardship and mental manipulation and just emotional trauma to finally find who I was looking for. And each person goes about it in their own way. Mine wasn't exactly the best way, but it led me to the person I have today. Which, of course, is the hubby that I always love to talk about. You never want to give up, really. It doesn't matter how many people you date in your life. It doesn't matter how few people. Don't think of your love life as something to be compared to. What you really want to do is, like I said, take each relationship take it every day. Don't think long term in that moment. Just take it day by day, because you never know really what's going to happen. What I did was stupid. I thought each guy I was with was going to be the person I married, the person who was going to put a ring on me, blah, 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 blah. And some of them even convinced me that that was going to be true, and I believed them. But in a long term sense, looking back, it was kind of obvious it wasn't going to happen. So heed my advice. Take relationships day by day. Don't think ahead to the future. Don't expect too much. Even if you've been with them a long time, because you never really know what's going to happen. The only way you can be absolutely certain, well, only you can tell. I found out about mine a year and a half ago. And I'm definitely certain, but I'm also a little older than I once was, a little wiser than I used to be. Take each relationship day by day. That way, if something happens, it's going to hurt, but you won't see yourself as losing your future. Because I always thought that I was never going to have a future, that I was going to be older when I got married and no chance for kids, or maybe even no chance to have a family. But that's not exactly true. Not anymore. I know what my future is. I know I'm going to have kids, and I know I'm going to have a great life. And that's because I learned through my sufferings and my challenges along the way. And that's exactly what I want for you guys. Learn, grow, and don't get your hopes up. You'll know it when you know it. If you're thinking and you're second guessing, maybe that person's not for you. But if you aren't second guessing, if you can look this person every day in their eyes and feel new love for them, then you know it's that person. Because that's what I feel when I look at hubby. Every morning when I wake him up and I look into his eyes, my heart flutters with new love every day. And he always surprises me every single day. And there are these little moments every so often that just make me fall more in love with him. And you'll know those moments. Don't force them. Don't try and make it happen. Just let it happen. And once it does, you'll know. And trust me, once you know, it's the best feeling in the world. Anyway, that's my advice for you guys. Take my extended love life and as a lesson. And make sure that you guys are being safe with who you let into your heart. Don't damage it. Just be cautious. Bye, little skeletons. Love you guys. Stay safe.